I hadn't done anything wrong. I didn't break any law or commit any crime.
In 2011, professional footballer Zahir Belounis found himself trapped in Qatar, a victim of the kafala system that states that employees can only leave Qatar with permission from their employer. Belounis was in a legal fight with his club, who had stopped paying his salary. In this battle, the club used the kafala system to pressure Belounis to waive any claims against it. Refusing meant that Belounis, with his wife and two daughters, had to live in Qatar without any income.
I'm not a symbol, just a footballer who wanted to keep my family alive by practicing my profession. Just a man who said no, who wanted to be respected. A man they tried to break.
Things got bleak for Belounis and his family, until various international parties stepped in. Following an international campaign by players' unions, trade unions networks, human rights organizations, and government, Belounis eventually received his Qatari exit visa in November 2013 without compromising his financial settlement. Belounis was not the only player trapped. He shared a destiny with thousands of migrant construction workers. After multiple complaints and the influence of the international human rights community, government and football organizations, Qatari ultimately accepted to reform its labor laws and the kafala system for all migrant workers. Zahir Belounis's resistance against systemic oppression, abuse of power and violation of fundamental rights shines light for the world to pay attention to the plight of migrant workers and the fight for the respect of their basic human rights.